name is Felipe. I've been working with Inkscape since 2007, but today I'm going to talk about another project that was started last year, which is GNU Libre DWG. It's a library that is part of the GNU project to handle DWG files from AutoCAD, which is a proprietary secret file format. So it involves a lot of reverse engineering of file format. So the background of this project is that in University of São Paulo, where I used to study engineering, I used to talk a lot about free software to the students and to the teachers and so on. And we decided to form a user group, which is called Poly GNU. Poly is a reference to the name of our school, which is Polytechnic School. So Poly GNU. And then the first project that we have done was to install free software on one of the laboratories where we were having our weekly meetings. So in this same laboratory, there were other projects happening, and most of them were related to civil engineering and architecture. So we knew that once new projects needed CAD, computer-aided design software, they would probably want to come reinstall Windows and so on because of AutoCAD. So we wanted to provide a solution even before they requested that, because we knew it would happen sooner or later. So the first project we did was trying to figure out what is the current state of free software CAD tools. So we listed everything we found in a table with, this is not the complete table, but it looked like that, with features we wanted. Sorry, that's in Portuguese, but I can translate something. But these are several features that we thought that people would want in a CAD software, and these are some of the CAD softwares we found. There are more. These are just some of them. And one thing that we noticed is that absolutely all of the free software we found did not have support for DWG file format. So we decided to do something about it. By looking on the internet for references to the file format, we figure out Open Design Alliance, which is a consortium of the competitors of Autodesk, that they wanted to have interoperability with content created by AutoCAD users. So the DWG file format as a secret was a barrier to their participation in the market. So they decided to get together and reverse engineer the file format. So it was not us free software developers that reverse engineered that. It was the other proprietary CAD tools developers that decided to reverse engineer the file format. And they released a document, an unofficial specification of the file format that is not perfect. There are some portions of the specification where they simply say, oh, here goes a value, and we don't know what this means. And I just know it's a 8-bit value or 16-bit value, or even strange things like fields that have a variable number of bits, because the DWG format is oriented at the bit level. So it's a bit stream you go parsing. It's not necessarily aligned at byte boundaries. So there are some fields that are unknown, but this is a 180 pages document. And then we found a free software library called libDWG, which was working based on this specification to implement DWG support in free software, because these guys have released a proprietary library for them to use and for actually for anybody to use, but it's proprietary. So, and at the time it was free. I mean gratis. You didn't have to pay. And nowadays it's not free as in freedom, but also not free as in free beer. And then this guy took that documentation and started implementing it. But there was two problems. It was one guy alone working on the project. And the other problem is, as you can see in this page, they have documentations in English, Portuguese, and Esperanto. But this guy, he decided to implement the library in C language, but with comments and data structures and variables and everything else in Esperanto. So it was a little bit hard to understand his code. So we thought that, wow, that's very nice of him to be so in love with this romantic idea of a universal and not political biased language, but we need to have more developers. So we tried to not be impolite, but we did fork. So we have forked, and we just to translate to English. But then he was covering 20% of the specification. 20% of what was written in the specification was implemented, and just for reading decoding routines, not encoding routines. So after we almost finished translating, because nowadays we still have some words in Esperanto in some parts of the code, but well, almost everything is translated to English. But then we decided to continue the work, and then nowadays we have almost 100% of both encoding and decoding routines implemented, but not tested. So one thing that we need is to have a test suite with DWG files and so on. I'll talk about that later. Another thing that we figure out, but not at first, it took some time for us to discover, was that the Free Software Foundation had do you know the high priority projects list? It's a list of projects that the Free Software Foundation considers a priority for the free software movement. Stuff like PDF and Flash Player and so on. So they have a list of, I think, 15 projects. And one of these projects was implement free software alternatives for the OpenDWG libraries, which are proprietary. So as this was one of the high priority projects, we decided to submit a form in order to become a part of the GNU project. So it was accepted, and now we are officially a GNU package. Our website is gnu.org/software/libre-dwg. And this year we are participating in the Summer of Code through the GNU project. So we have one student that is also Brazilian. Did I mention I'm from Brazil? Okay, I'm from Brazil. And both developers are from Brazil. And this student is also from Brazil, from the same school. Yeah, it's biased. And he's going to work on the DWG write support. We have the routines implemented, but we do not have testing. And decoding is easy, because if you miss something, okay, you're just reading a portion of the data. But encoding must be perfect in order to other software understand it as not a corrupted file. So encoding is really harder. I think that's a generic statement about data formats. I think it's very common to be harder to implement encoding routines. And he's gonna be working on that. But there's also some other guys from around the world that are participating in the project. And one thing that one of them is doing is a test suite. This is some examples of files that we have opened and converted into SVG. DWG allows 3D stuff and a lots of stuff that SVG does not support. But as I had a background in the Inkscape development, so I was familiar with SVG. So in order to test the 2D primitives, I decided to implement a converter to this subset of what DWG is capable of representing. There are some bugs here. As you can see, the strings are not showing up properly. This is Inkscape loading an SVG that was generated based on a DWG file. I have a PDF of this file that we have used as a reference to see how it should look like. I can show it here. Okay, so this is the complete document rendered in a PDF. So these small views of the house is one of these, and there's also a view from the top that we have here. Yeah, several views, and from the top, we have some bugs here, but these bugs are in the SVG converter, not necessarily on the library, because LibreWG is focused only on parsing the file format, not really dealing with the semantics of the contents. This would be a second step for maybe a second library, or the application can deal with it, because it's good to separate things. It's really hard to parse this file format, so we're just loading our DWG file and initializing the values of data C data structures, so that other libraries or applications can use it. So this in this case, the SVG converter is defining default color of the strokes. It's blue by default. It's not what is reading from the file. It's simplified. There's lots of things that are not showing up here, but they are already loaded into the C data structures. It's just that my example SVG converter does not handle what the library has loaded, because we have almost everything implemented already. So except for bugs, probably the information is there. It's just a matter of the application not using it still not using it. So ways to help. There are some objects, such as the 3D solid entity, that have an embedded file format called SAT, or SAB, which is save as text or save as binary. And ACES is the name of a computer-aided design kernel. And this is a file format that they used to use in this kernel. And DWG uses it to store the 3D modeling data. And this is another proprietary non-documented format inside a proprietary undocumented format. So it requires some secondary library also to handle it. The DWG versions change from time to time. So there are some fields that are only in the newer versions. So the 2007 version has a header that is encoded using Reed-Solomon algorithm, but we do not know which are the initializing parameters for the algorithm, so it works as encryption. It's not I think it's not intended to be encryption, but as we don't know the initial parameters, we have to guess all of them in order to figure out which one is the correct one. So this is something we still do not handle properly. So the DWG file, the most recent format is 2010. We have no implementation of this version. We already handle files from R13, 14, 15, which is 2000 and 2004. 2007, we can handle except for the headers. We are thinking about implementing Python bindings for the library because there are lots of free software CAD tools implemented in Python. We are working on a test suite. One of the ideas we have is to write a Lisp or VB script to run in AutoCAD to generate a XML file that represents the data structures of the loaded DWG file in AutoCAD, and then do the same in our application that uses our library to generate an equivalent XML, and then compare this. We're thinking of using XML as an intermediate comparison means to see what's not properly loaded by our library nowadays. We also need samples of DWG files that we can freely distribute as a test suite. This file I'm showing here is one of our contributors. It's content from his paid work, so probably he cannot share it with the world. He has sent it by mail to me so that I can test it, but I cannot put it in a repository and share with the world. So in order to automate, we would need people to provide us DWG samples, and ideally complex files. We need to test it a lot, and we need to figure out how 2010 format works. And this is our contact, our website in the GNU project, mailing list, and Juca is my nickname, Juca, and Pitanga is the other maintainer. Thank you. Questions?
Thank you very much. We take two questions. First question.
Nice work, really, really amazing. But do you consider that maybe your work, unless the right method implementation, maybe it's illegal in countries with software patents and
I do not know of any patents on the DWG file, and I do not want to know. but fuck, I'll do it. Another issue with the encoding routines is that some people told us that we should not support encoding, but I think we should. I do not like DWG format. It's a hell to parse, and it's a totally obfuscated file format. The whole purpose of LibreDWG is a project to not be needed anymore. So we want to provide it just as a means for people to bring their stuff into free software and convert it to something safe and never use it anymore. So it's good to have the encoding routines because we know I am an idealistic person, but I am aware that the world is not changing immediately to something else. So we need to have a way to people to actually use free software, and I think it's not fair to have, for example, in a hypothetical case where we have a free software implementation that is even better than the proprietary ones, and we just cannot move to it because there's locks based on file formats. So I think it's important, just like Microsoft formats are supported in OpenOffice, and I think it's a really important thing to have both encoding and decoding support for their proprietary file formats. It's the same here.
Thank you. Second question, anyone? There. Can you come to the front? I'm sorry.
I heard about DXF file format, which is a brother of DWG. Mm-hmm. How about this format?
This format is already supported by lots of free software projects. It was one of the items in our table. As you can see, Archimedes can read it, KiCad can both read and write, and la la la. So there is already support for it. It's less complicated to understand because it's a text-based format. And it's not exactly equivalent, but it's a subset of the things that DWG can do. I cannot say which specific features one lacks because it's just something that my friend told me. So I believe that he said to me, I'm not sure, he said to me that it's not equivalent. But the fact is that people have DWG files and people want to load them and people don't want to be bothered about. You know, it must be so easy as people wouldn't give up using free software because of this. So I think we should have both supported.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.